Hey everybody, welcome back to Bud Lights Camera Action. This week we are bringing you a movie about the worst holiday ever, Valentine's Day, complete with a cast of about a million people. This movie was really hard to follow, so bear with us and let's just get into it.
Valentine's Day is about anger, disappointment,
love,
romance,
mating,
discretion,
sparkly,
commitment.
I love it. I love hype.
You're the most special Valentine I have ever had. But just don't tell the other kids we had a date in the bar. It's just a little inappropriate.
All right. Well, welcome to the most depressing love story you could ever have. Almost, kind of. I don't know.
92.5 The Love Bug, sponsored by Mucinex. It's Valentine's Day.
That was pretty. That was good. That was good.
And that is the opening of this movie. A radio DJ on a pump station.
Yeah.
I was trying to immerse the people into what they were getting themselves into.
You're not ready. Nobody was ready. Nobody should be subjected to this movie. This is, of course, Bud Lights Camera Action. Me amo Mike.
Yo soy amor.
No. That's not a good sentence. I was just explaining to Anthony. I was just watching Predator in Spanish on a Spanish channel, as well as flipping back and forth to the classic Made in Manhattan. Honestly, quick point about that movie. And it doesn't hold up. It sucks even worse than before.
You should have watched it in Spanish.
I wish. If it was in Spanish, I would have watched. But, like, Predator in Spanish was much better.
We should run all these movies back and see if they're better or worse in Spanish.
I would probably say that they would be better because I didn't understand some of them to begin with.
Well, you're going to have some trouble understanding this one.
Good point.
Wow. What a cluster of a movie.
Go ahead, start.
Valentine's Day.
Yeah, that's right. The movie this week is Valentine's Day. Sorry about missing last week. Anthony and I have been traveling a lot. You know.
We really have been.
We've been traveling a lot.
Seattle City.
Yeah, Nashville, Seattle, because our lives are dope and we do dope shit. So
yeah, kings do king shit.
Kings do king shit.
So this is a lovely ensemble of a cast, and
you know
it just follows the lives of normal people like you and I, you know, professional NFL quarterbacks.
Yeah.
Army veterans.
Yep.
A flower man.
Yep.
And just a normal working stiff.
Well, no, I mean, there's others.
There's a lot more. There's a lot more, but, you know. Yeah. Oh, a sports agent.
A sports agent, a sportscaster.
A sportscaster.
A doctor, a teacher.
Pretty much the lives of everyone.
Yeah, everyone. Holy shit.
And
this movie is about everyone in the entire world.
Everyone you know.
Oh, I hate this movie.
This is how they spent their Valentine's Day.
Yeah. Oh, and I'm going to give a spoiler right now. Everyone in this fucking movie is connected in some way or another.
Yep.
And
that's what makes it great.
Oh, it made me so mad. So Anthony said that there were a lot of, stars in this movie. I timed it. There are 2.5 minutes worth of credits. And, like, it's 2.5 minutes. And it's not, like, credits where, like, they're rolling off names that you don't know. Like, it's crazy. Like, I'm looking at the IMDb page right now. I'm going to just rattle off a couple names on here. Jessica Alba, Kathy Bates, Jessica Biel, Bradley Cooper, Patrick Dempsey, Jamie Foxx, Jennifer Garner, Topher Grace, Anne Hathaway, Ashton Kutcher, Queen Latifah, Taylor Lautner, Taylor Swift. Like, are you kidding me?
Can I just say that this movie had three of my least favorite, four of my least favorite people in Hollywood?
Are they? Let me guess them.
Can you guess them? I mean, yeah, this is a fun game.
Okay.
Guess them, please.
I will guess them. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to say that Taylor Swift is one.
She's number one.
Okay.
I hate her the most out of anybody.
I thought so.
In the entire world.
I am going to say that another one is Anne Hathaway.
Wrong.
What?
I'm actually a huge Anne Hathaway fan.
Oh, I hate Anne Hathaway.
I thought she was great in this. She was a delight.
Actually, you know what? I hate Anne Hathaway, but, you know, she was all right in this. Okay.
She almost redeemed it. Her and Jamie Foxx.
Yeah, Jamie Foxx was cool. Jessica Biel was cool,
that's
too.
About it. Yeah, Jessica Biel was cool.
How about Taylor? Right, Taylor Lautner.
100%. Yeah. Worst actor ever.
Yeah, I don't. Okay, here's an easy one. I hope we agree on this one. George Lopez.
Yes.
Yes.
That was number one. As soon as I saw George Lopez, I said to myself, "How did he get this job?"
I know. The last one, is it Topher Grace?
No, it's not Topher Grace.
Oh, I hate Topher Grace.
No, it's not Topher Grace.
Is it Ashton Kutcher?
Nope.
Oh.
Nope.
Hmm.
It's a woman.
It's a woman?
Yeah.
Is it Julia Roberts?
It's not Julia Roberts. She's great.
What the fuck, man?
She's American. Queen Latifah, man.
Oh, come on. Jersey, represent.
I don't like her.
Eh.
I don't like her.
No, I'm not saying I like her either. I'm just saying.
I don't want to see her in a movie.
There's people I dislike more than her. Okay.
In this movie? Well, so, yeah.
Yeah, in this movie.
Anne Hathaway was great. So we start with Jessica Alba, by the way.
Oh, yeah. First note off the bat, Jessica Alba is perfect. She is flawless. Like, she's sleeping.
In the very first scene.
Yeah, the movie starts. She's sleeping, and I fell in love immediately.
Did you notice the sign over the bed? It said frolic room.
Did it really?
That was hilarious. I think I'm going to go to Pier 1 Imports and pick me up a frolic room sign for my bedroom.
Please do. Please do.
Because that is hilarious.
Okay, so Jessica Alba is dating Ashton Kutcher.
Ashton Kutcher, yeah.
So he wakes up and he's trying to propose to her. He says he has like a little speech and he says, "If you're ever with a girl that's too good for you, marry her." And honestly, love that line. I love that line.
You do?
Yeah, I actually did. It's a good line, bro. I'm going to use that when I get married. If I get married, I'm not going to get married.
You would have been married 8 times already. Every girl you've been with was too good for you.
Mm. Yeah, I agree. I can't deny any of that. Oh, shit. Okay. All right. Fuck you.
but please don't propose to your future wife on Valentine's Day.
If she looks like Jessica Alba, I would. Oh, yes. On Valentine's Day. Thank you, because I actually think that is incredibly corny.
Yeah, it is. It's just as bad as New Year's Day.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's really bad. It's really bad.
You know what's a good time to propose to someone?
Never.
On a random day.
Yeah.
Never.
Never.
Yeah, you're right.
I think that's... Never.
I'm with you on that one. If you gotta do it, but do it on a random day. Like,
yeah.
Like, I don't know. June 3rd.
Do it on Arbor Day.
No, it can't be any day. It has to be your day.
Yeah, but you gotta do it on a day that you're never gonna forget your anniversary.
True.
Yeah, you know?
All right.
Like, do it... Like, my birthday is the 11th, so I'll probably propose to a girl on the 11th, so all I have to do is remember the month.
Do it on your half birthday. Ooh, that's
yeah,
that's
yeah. Dude, see, this is, you know, this podcast is more than just movies. This is
maybe not a great movie, but a lot of life lessons.
This is great life lessons. Jessica Alba agrees to marry Ashton Kutcher. And immediately, like, you can tell that there's reluctance.
Yes.
Like, she wasn't thrilled about it. But, so, I mean, whatever. It was weird. I didn't like the scene. I didn't like the movie.
The
The dog in it was a good actor.
Both the dogs were good actors.
What was the second dog?
There were two dogs. The second dog was Emma Roberts' dog.
Oh, yeah. That dog was good, too.
Yeah, the acting... you know what? The dogs were better actors than Taylor Swift.
Oh, my God. Fuck. She was so annoying in this movie. I want Tommy to watch this movie and like, look me in the eyes and tell me that she's not annoying in this movie.
He'll still say that she isn't.
I agree, but, like, Taylor Swift... fans are so, like, brainwashed.
The worst. Tom, I know if you're listening to this, sorry, but your girl sucks.
Yeah, Tom, fuck you. No, sorry, man, I love you. So, you know, after this, we're kind of following around Ashton Kutcher, and you think he's going to be the main character through the movie? Not really.
Everyone kind of is. Like, they spend about 5 minutes on everybody.
Yeah. The plot went nowhere with any character.
Yeah, no, there was no development. The only development that had was with Jennifer Garner.
Yeah. Which, she was annoying as fuck in this movie. We'll get to her. We'll get to her. Don't worry.
She's not great.
We'll get to her.
How about we go through every individual character's journey?
Why? Okay, I guess that's what we embarked upon.
We can't do this literally.
Oh, wait a second. Hold on. Made in Manhattan is still on my other screen, and they're about to do the montage from episode one that we talked about. The clothes montage.
Great.
Yeah, so I'm going to be in a good mood for the next, like, 2 minutes. Ashton Kutcher just made, like, a throwaway line in this movie, and he said that 110 million roses are sold every year on Valentine's Day.
Uh-huh.
I did the research. He's wrong. In 2010, 198 million were sold. Do you know when this movie came out? 2010. Fuck you, Ashton Kutcher.
That was so wrong.
Yeah, it was way wrong.
That's a lot of roses.
That's an insane number. I thought that was high, and then when I actually saw the real number, I was like, whoa. That's impressive.
Here's my take.
We should just...
That's so unoriginal.
I know.
You're doing the same thing as like 100 million other people. Do something different.
Yeah, I agree. I can agree with you, buddy.
You know what I'm saying? Like, do a polar plunge on Valentine's Day.
True, dude. I heard that. I don't even know where the fuck we are in this movie right now. Like, I'm already lost. We're like two scenes in.
We're still in the first scene.
Yeah, alright.
So Ashton Kutcher's a florist.
Yeah.
He goes to work, delivering flowers. He's in a great mood because Jessica Alba just said yes. Anyone would be in a great mood.
Mm-hmm.
And, then we cut to Jennifer Garner. With McDreamy, right?
Yeah, Patrick Dempsey.
Patrick Dempsey. Yeah, that guy.
Yes.
And you can tell that this is an affair going on.
Oh, right off the bat. Patrick
Dempsey's always a scumbag in every movie.
Dude, I love Patrick Dempsey. He's the man.
Yeah. Well, so Patrick Dempsey has another family, but is stringing Jennifer Garner along.
Yes.
Jennifer Garner... is in love with him. She's a school teacher. She's the school teacher. He's the doctor.
Correct.
So we could check those two off. And then we go to an airplane. There's an airplane.
No, we're not there yet.
We really?
No, we are at Topher Grace and Anne Hathaway now.
Right.
So okay. Topher Grace and Anne Hathaway. I guess how long have they been dating? 2 months,
two
did they
weeks.
Say? Two weeks, right. Two weeks. So we get to them and, like, they're banging, or they, like, just finished banging. And, like, Topher Grace is just such a nerd. Like, he's such a nerd, man.
I don't think he is. And,
no, he is. I hate him. In Spider-Man 3,
All right, we won't talk about Spider-Man 3,
I know.
We watch a lot of terrible movies on this. Don't insult me with Spider-Man 3.
We're never watching that movie. Are you kidding
me? Yeah. Actually, was enough.
You know what? We might have to, because that movie is just legendarily bad.
I could do a whole hour on Tobey Maguire emo.
I know. I know. So now we find out that so like Topher Grace's character is like a big loser, pretty much. And we find out Anne Hathaway is a sex talker or a sex line operator.
Yes.
And she is not good at it either.
I thought she was pretty good as a Russian girl.
In the end, no, like later on in the movie, she's like good at it. Yeah, but like, yeah. You know, at the start, like she's falling off of her like stupid motorcycle, like the Faggio thing.
Yeah, the moped.
Yes, the Grand Theft Auto Faggio. So, she's not a good sex operator, and
now,
you know.
Now, don't let your bias against Anne Hathaway do her.
She's good later. She's good later, but I admit to that. But you can already see that now. That they set up all the conflicts so quickly.
Yeah.
So now you can see that conflict is going to be Topher Grace will eventually find out and he's going to freak out because he's like a nerd and he's not going to be able to live with that. Okay.
Yeah. So that's one storyline.
Yeah.
That's exactly what happens.
There's another one. Now I believe what we go to next now is the little fucking kid.
That was the worst.
I hated that kid. I hate that kid. Oh.
I hate any kid. There's so many movies where there's this little kid that's like thinks that he's in love.
Yes. Yeah.
Like get a fucking grip, kid.
Yeah.
You're like 10 years old.
Yeah. He was born in 99, and this was filmed by.
Sorry, he was 11. Yeah, he was 10.
Yeah, he was 10. Go fuck yourself, kid.
Were you ever in love when you were 10?
No.
Yeah, me either.
Dude, and you know, his name was Edison, too, which just pissed me off. Yeah. It was stupid.
Yeah, it was like, that's just California shit.
I hate this movie. But, all right, so this kid is, like, a little, like, hopeless romantic dweeb. And you can tell that he's going to be in love with someone in his class.
Mm-hmm.
And he is just the worst. He is... Like I said, Topher Grace was a nerd. This kid is just like when they eventually show him in the classroom, his teacher, who is Jennifer Gardner, I told you everyone's connected. His teacher leaves the room because she needs to talk to Ashton Kutcher, who is her best friend, and she leaves little fucking nerdy Edison in charge of the class, and he like. You know, he's like that typical kid that like gets a little bit of power and he like turns around and shushes all of his classmates. And it's like, dude, you're in like first grade or whatever. Like, fuck you.
Pretty sure he was in fourth grade.
I don't care. Elementary school. I'm really not good at figuring out like how old a kid is and like what grade that puts him in. It's a hard skill. That's a tough skill to have.
This is a tough skill. You're right.
It is.
It's like judging distance on water.
All right. I can see how they could be comparable. They're both difficult.
Yeah, both very hard. so
now
this nerd wants to get flowers for his crush. Of course, he goes to the only – apparently Ashton Kutcher's the only florist in fucking town.
No, we're not there yet, man.
All right. Well, like he wants to get it for her.
He wants to get flowers. We'll just leave it at that because that comes back.
Yeah.
Are we trying to go in like order of the movie, or do you just want to like ruin people's storylines, you know, single handedly?
Just ruin the story. I mean, they all go to the same place.
Yeah. They all end up in the same place. You know, like continuously throughout this movie.
All right. Let's just continue on.
All right, well, I'm just trying to introduce all the characters first.
Okay, yeah.
So now we have your favorite character, my favorite character too, Taylor Swift. And
God, fuck her.
Oh, fuck, man. Like, I've said it many times before. Like, the girl puts out amazing music. I love it. You can't hate on a T-Swift song.
Jams.
Absolute jams.
But she sucks.
Ugh.
And her in this movie is like – I think it's honestly, this is really who she is.
I was going to say that.
Like, times like 10.
Yep. I was going to say this is her turned up to 10. Like,
yeah. Because she can't act.
No. No.
Let's be honest. Like, did you watch the SNL 40?
Yeah. Oh, my God. She was the worst part of the entire show.
She was the only one who sucked.
I was like, I didn't know what she was doing.
Yeah, me either.
Like, I don't think she understood what she was supposed to be doing.
Me either, because everyone had, like, a normal accent, and she was just like, like always, a tryhard, because that's who she is.
Is she, yeah. Let's not get started on her, dude.
I could talk an hour.
Let's keep it to the character. Either. Let's just keep it to the character. I know I know your feelings towards her. So she is dating Taylor Lautner, who is just—he is such a douche in this too.
Yeah, he's a she has this huge like
teddy bear,
a huge teddy bear.
Yeah,
and she's like, "Oh my god, my boyfriend left it for me."
It was a decent impression, actually, because that is how she sounds in the movie.
That's exactly how she talked in the movie. And I guess she was going for, like, basic bitch. But, I mean, she nailed it, I guess.
Like you said, though, I think that's who she is.
I really think that's how she is. So we'll just keep moving on before I punch a hole in my wall.
I know. So from there, okay. So now we're at the plane. Only now are we at the plane, Anthony.
Yeah. You 30 minutes in.
Yeah, you thought this was, like, the second one. No, that we are almost out of characters now. We're not even close to, actually.
Two Oscar nominees and winners.
And we are now going to meet the hottest person in the movie. Not Julia Roberts. Yes, Bradley Cooper. Like, Bradley Cooper, I mean, he's just a good-looking guy, man. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I mean, he is. Other than Jessica Alba,
Well, I mean, like, Alba, Beale.
Yeah, Alba, Beale, then Bradley Cooper, I think.
I think that's fair. 100%, I really think that's fair.
Emma Roberts.
Yeah, but she's not on that. She's not on that level. Like, I think Emma Roberts is really, really good looking. I don't think she's on that level.
Well, all right.
It's just. I'm just saying.
I'll go with it.
Okay.
They're tied for third, and then everyone else is kind of a nerd.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So, can you explain the plane going on? So
they're on a plane. They're on a 14-hour trip. Julia Roberts is actually a captain in the Army, did she say?
She is a captain.
Captain?
Yeah.
Yeah, so she's going to, see a special someone on Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
And, Bradley Cooper wants to befriends her.
Yes. Bradley Cooper's character is very – yeah, Bradley Cooper's character is very friendly. He's a good guy.
He's a great guy. Yeah. And so they become friends and they start chatting it up and Julia Roberts is like, yeah, I'm coming. Like I'm seeing someone for Valentine's Day, a real special someone. Okay. So then we move on. They're on the plane for the whole movie. Until the end.
Yeah, right. Yeah. No, so, you're right.
I mean, we could just drop it right there. They're on the plane for the rest of the movie.
That's yeah, all, you know? not much happens with them.
No, just Bradley Cooper being charming and Julia Roberts.
Yeah, you kind of think like they're gonna hook up almost.
Nah.
I don't know. Oh, okay. So this is where – okay, so now – Anthony said before, like, the whole Jennifer Gardner, Patrick Dempsey thing is that he has a family. He has a wife and kids. So he leaves. Where does this all take place?
L.A.
And he leaves and goes to San Francisco, I think?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, okay. So her brilliant idea is that she's going to fly out on Valentine's Day and surprise him. Ladies, never do that. It's a bad idea. Number one.
It's a terrible idea.
Number one.
We already tackled these subjects in the other woman.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. We did. Yeah. Like, number one, he's probably cheating on you. Number two, even if he's not cheating on you, you are now thrusting yourself into a situation that you were not supposed to be. And it's not going to be greeted as, like, an amazing thing.
Yeah. No, not at all.
So, I don't know.
I don't care what day it is. Just don't do it.
Yeah, don't. Yeah, don't. That's, I don't know. It's not a great idea. But.
Wouldn't she think that it was a little fishy? I mean, that
I know.
Just, like, leave her on Valentine's Day if they were together?
Yeah,
like,
but he.
You gotta read the signs.
No, but yeah, but he was a doctor, and he said that he had surgery that day. It's believable.
All right.
It's believable. I don't know who the wife is. I've been trying to find it. She's so much better looking than Jennifer Garner, though.
You know, I've seen Jennifer Garner before in real life.
Really?
Yeah, she walked right past me when I was working at a hotel.
No shit.
She's a very small woman. She's about 5 foot nothing.
Do you think you could dunk on her?
I think I might be able to dunk on her. She also wears a lot of makeup, but she looked pretty friendly. I don't know. I don't want to talk shit about her.
All right. I mean, whatever. I don't have any ill will towards her. Look up, though.
She's a nice lady.
Yeah, look up Catherine Lanassa, Lanasa. That is Patrick Dempsey's wife in the movie. I think she's a good-looking woman. She's quite good-looking. Apparently,
she's.
I guess she had
She is, and guess what? She's nearly 50.
I know. I guess she had a reoccurring role on Two and a Half Men. Because I'm seeing a lot of pictures from that. Not like I fucking hate that show, but I'm just saying.
She was in the campaign.
Yeah, she was Will Ferrell's wife.
Yeah, Rose Brady.
Yeah. But, all right, so back to this car crash. I don't know what this means. Why did I write down midgets with flowers? Do you have any idea what that means?
I have no clue. Maybe you're talking about George Lopez.
Oh, okay. No, I actually got it. There's a lot of cut scenes in this movie where, it'll just be, a cut scene of people reacting to something that, had just happened in the actual movie. But they're all just extras. And they're all supposed to be, since it's Valentine's Day, it's just, people making out or people giving each other flowers and candy and whatever. And
I've never seen such a police celebrate Valentine's Day.
No, me neither. Me neither. It was weird. But no, I never have. One of the cutscenes, though, I guess this was just two midgets giving each other flowers.
I mean,
it's
pretty funny. Yeah, everyone celebrates it. It's
I'm not discriminating against little people by any means. I'm just saying, it was funny. They were just both sitting on a bench, and they were just, I was like, oh, okay.
That is pretty random, dude.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. It was just random.
Do you think that was a candid shot, or do you think that was set up?
No, absolutely everything in this movie was set up. There was nothing candid
about it. You're right, because who celebrates Valentine's Day in such a fashion? As all of these people.
No one. This was such a Hollywood,
contrived.
Yes, dramatization of it.
You're right, because I feel like Valentine's Day has really been dying lately. They're trying to revive it.
As it should. It should, man. I have a fun fact about myself. I have never had, a Valentine.
Wow. What?
Yeah, I've never had a Valentine's Day dinner and, given a girl, a present saying, oh, you're my Valentine, let's exchange gifts. I've never had that.
Wow. I feel kind of bad for you, dude.
It's kind of nice. No, it's not like a – is it? Fuck you. I thought you were going to be like, oh, don't worry about it. It's not a – fuck you. Nah.
I'm just fucking with you.
Nah.
You think you want that kind of pressure?
No, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. That's why I'm cool with not having, like, any of that pressure.
Like, it's worse than, like, a girl's birthday.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, because there's, like –
you can't forget Valentine's Day, no, God forbid.
It is such a hyped up, like, just made up, like, corporate holiday. That's really what it is. And, yes. I just don't agree with it.
And you're such a nonconformist.
I try to be, man.
So you're sounding a lot like Jamie Foxx in this movie, man.
Down
like
with the man.
From New Year's to St. Patrick's Day, no charm, no swag, nothing. Sweatpants, but sweatpants. Yeah.
Jamie Foxx was probably the best character in this movie, though.
I agree.
He was real. He was a real person.
Yeah, but then he ends up with Jessica Biel.
Yeah, good for him. He wins.
And Jessica Biel's throwing a I Hate Valentine's Day party.
Yeah, that was so lame, too. Yeah, that was like the depiction of like the single woman.
Not liking it, yeah. But to throw a fucking lame ass party like that.
Yeah,
like,
but she, you know what? She wasn't even that bad. Like, she does have her breakdown later in the movie where she, like, she's crying and she's like, what's wrong with me? Blah, blah, blah. And yeah, whatever. I don't care.
I guess, but I don't think normal people behave this way.
I don't either. Absolutely not.
Except Taylor Swift. She's the only person who behaves agreed. The way she behaves in this movie.
Yeah, Taylor Swift and Taylor Lautner were actually dating while they were filming this movie.
Yeah, that sounds like the couple from fucking hell. All right. Could you imagine double dating that couple?
No. Double suicide, maybe.
Like going on a double
murder suicide.
Taylor Lautner and Taylor Swift. Could you think of a couple that you would least want to go on a double date with? I don't think you can. If you can, please comment us. And let us know.
Holy shit, that's a good idea. I'm going to try to come up with one before the end of the episode, but I don't think I can.
Yeah, impossible. It's impossible.
People are going to say, like, Kim and Kanye, but that would be entertaining as shit.
No, that would be hilarious.
Yeah, Kanye is the man. That would be hilarious.
That would be really funny. But it's really close, though. Kim Kardashian almost makes up.
You'd get to look at her the whole time, though. You'd get to look at her the whole time.
That's true, and she's not going to be like – see, Taylor Swift is the kind of girl, like, if you're looking at her, she'll call you out on dinner.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll be like, I'm not looking at you. I'm just, like, staring because, like, I can't imagine someone being this shitty.
Yeah. Yeah,
but then
she'll
call you out, too, for staring at her. And be like, listen, sweetheart, you're nothing special.
Dude, you really have it out for Taylor Swift.
I hope she listens to this.
Yeah. Yeah, that'll happen. All right, so that fucking kid, what's his name? Einstein?
Edison.
We're calling him Einstein.
We're calling him Einstein. So, dude, I mean, yeah. Edison, you know, Einstein.
The
fucking inventor.
Right, exactly. So Einstein is a dick, dude. Einstein, this little nerd, he goes into Ashton Kutcher's flower shop. Mm-hmm. And he's like, I need I'm gonna imitate him. He's like, I need a dozen roses for the prettiest girl in my class. Mister, you need to bring it and you need to write a card. Just bring it during recess and I'll come up and find you. You'll know it's her because she's the prettiest girl in my class. Fuck you, Einstein. Fuck you, Einstein.
That was impressive. Dude.
Acting. So you know, all this happens, and Ashton Kutcher's just like, oh, who brought the cutest kid in the world to my shop? Ashton Kutcher, fuck you, because that kid sucks. I hate that kid. So now he pulls the screw job, and the kid buys a dozen roses and gives him $15. Ashton Kutcher says that they cost $55, and he just leaves him. He leaves him $15.
$15.
Yeah, I want to look up how much a dozen roses actually cost.
Yeah, dude, it's like $65.
That's good. Yeah.
It's fucking expensive.
Oh, wait. Proflower.com, $24.99.
Dude, then you have to pay.
Inflation.
You have to pay for them to deliver it.
Hmm.
That's how they get you.
Oh, wait a second. I have bought a girl a dozen roses. Was it for Valentine's Day? Yeah, I believe it was.
You sure?
Yeah, it was.
Here you are, making me feel like an asshole.
No, but it wasn't like on Valentine's Day. It was like afterwards.
It was the day before, right?
No, it was like a month after.
You bought a girl flowers in March?
Yeah. Because I think that's when we could see each other. It's a weird story. I don't want to get into it, but
I'm not going to air you out right now.
I'll talk to you later. yeah, just like fuck Einstein, dude. I wouldn't have delivered the flowers.
No, it would have been like $15 gets you one fucking flower. Yeah. Kid. You get to deliver one flower to her.
Yeah, here's a rose, bitch. Get out of here with your fucking ugly face. Grow some right, pubes no, and get the fuck out of my store.
Enough with the kid.
No, oh, I hate that fucking
kid. Leave him alone.
No, dude. You went on a diatribe about Taylor Swift.
Yeah, well, she's of age. She's an adult. She shouldn't be behaving this way. This kid's 10.
Yeah, but how old is he now? He was born in 99?
He's 16 now.
Yeah. That's legal age to get his ass beat.
Yeah, but he's probably not acting this way now at 16. He's probably saw the error of his ways.
Nah,
I
bet he still is. That kid's a loser.
No, he's probably still trying to give flowers to girls in high school.
He was in Marley and Me. Good for him. Nah, I'm just kidding. Fuck this kid. all right, so now we're going to – oh, so the quarterback.
Yes.
Holy shit, we're still not done with all the characters.
This is the last one. The quarterback's the last
one. No, it's not, dude. Yeah, so there's a quarterback, and I guess he's in something. I don't know who this guy is. He was in, like, a gay show. Oh, Grey's Anatomy. Yeah, he's in Grey's Anatomy. So he's the oldest quarterback in the league, and he's 35. Peyton Manning's 38. Tom Brady's 37. Drew Brees is 35. Another error, stupid fucking Valentine's Day. He's got it bad. You can tell there's something wrong with him. He throws out a tooth, like a second toothbrush in his house. He just went through a bad breakup. And you're just like, poor guy, you know. They say that, like, he's washed up. I guess he just lost the Super Bowl or, like, he just lost a championship game.
Yeah, it was a championship game.
Yeah, okay. So, like, they're saying that he should retire, he's done, whatever. And he calls his agent, or his PR person, which is Jessica Biel. So Jessica Biel is running on a treadmill and cannot figure out how to turn the treadmill off. She literally can't turn the treadmill off.
Looks like she does it every day. I don't understand what her deal is.
Right, exactly. I don't know. Whatever. She's kind of a mess because it's Valentine's Day. I don't care. It's a stupid storyline.
We already covered her. She throws a party for herself.
Yeah, exactly.
Fall in love with J-Fox, boom, bing, bang, boom. Two people who hate Valentine's Day like Valentine's Day now because this is an unrealistic fucking movie.
Yeah, we can just wrap that whole storyline up. Yeah, Jamie Foxx and Jessica Biel end up like hooking up at the end of the movie at her I Hate Valentine's Day party. Boom. Mm-hmm. Or after at work or whatever. I don't fucking care. This is the part of the movie where Taylor Swift, like, she was bad in the beginning. She is so much worse now. The part where she's getting interviewed at the high school.
I really didn't want to talk about this.
No, we got it.
All right, well, the dance that she does, she does the same exact dance at every fucking awards show.
I know.
And that's how you know that it's really her.
Yeah.
because like the camera always cuts to her during those award shows, and she's dancing. So, like, it could be any song, and she'll do that stupid fucking dance.
Stop. I told you, we're not getting into her as a person. If you want to make a beat down on her, there's other outlets to do it. We're talking about the movie.
Okay. Well, that thing was terrible.
Yes. That was awful. So she keeps – Yeah. She keeps dancing, and she's, like, being annoying. Like, she is, like, really being just, like, an annoying L.A. girl, like, to the T, and, like, really just pushing it. Like, ugh. She's so bad. And, like, Taylor Lautner is just – he's, like – he's supposed to be, like, a dumb jock. And they're just the worst couple in the world.
Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good
form over the hurdles. Oh, the form over the hurdles? Terrible.
No, it was pretty good.
It was actually pretty good. But he falls. He, like, eats shit.
Yeah, well, he was distracted by his girlfriend's terrible dancing. Yeah. Don't watch that scene. Yeah. Don't watch that scene. I don't care.
Yeah.
Let's move on.
Yeah. They cut back to the plane. Like we said, nothing happens on the plane, really, with Julia Roberts and Bradley Cooper. But Julia Roberts is talking to like on the plane, and she is talking so loud, and it was so rude, and it really like I think it pissed me off because on our flight down to Nashville last week, when there were girls sitting behind us, and they were so loud, and they were talking about just like weird shit. Like they were talking about periods and getting pregnant, and like their boyfriends, praying that their boyfriends would propose to them, and it was like it was very weird. Matt,
especially because you had a 7 a.m. flight.
Yeah, a 7 a.m. flight. And they are, like, going off. And I'm trying to read a book, dude. I don't read a lot. I'm not very literate.
You were reading a book?
Yeah, it was a sweet book, though. It was a –
What book are you reading?
It's a Navy SEALs book. It's a Navy SEALs book. No Easy Days. It's about when the Navy SEAL team that killed bin Laden. Yeah. So I'm trying to read it, and I'm getting, like, really into it. And, like, all I can hear is these friggin' hags talking behind me, like – but I don't even want to get into what they were talking about. It's gross, but they're annoying and I fucking hate them.
So don't talk on the plane.
Yeah, don't talk on a plane. That's rude.
Or else Mike's gonna come after you.
It's rude.
Beat you up in the head with the book that he's pretending to read.
Yeah, pretending there were pictures, thankfully, in the book. So now we are. Oh my god, dude! Seriously. We're at Emma Roberts and her boyfriend. Like, this is the first that they're introduced in this movie. Mm-hmm. And they're a high school couple that are going to have sex for the first time on Valentine's Day. The boyfriend leaves school and goes to Emma Roberts' house to, like, set up. And,
he's going to be playing a song naked on her bed.
Yeah.
But the second best actor in the movie.
Yes,
the dog.
Yeah. His name was like Poopsie. It was a weird name.
Didn't catch the name.
Yeah, I heard it a lot. They say it a few times. Now Emma Roberts' mom comes home from work early for some reason. Walks upstairs and finds this kid standing there naked with a guitar over his wang. And the kid, like, freaks out. The kid, like, he freaks out, walks out of the room, and then runs out of the house. Like, the mom already was, like, you know, cool with what was going – not cool, but, like, she was weirded out. Why did the kid run out of the house naked? Why didn't he just get changed?
Because it's a movie.
Like, clearly that was an awkward situation because the mom knew that
so bad.
Her daughter was about to get banged. But he ran out of the house butt naked and just ran into the street.
You only pull a move like that in high school if the parents are on vacation.
Yeah. Anybody can come home from work.
Yeah.
You dummy.
At any time. You idiot.
Ugh. Fuck. Fuck. Fuck this movie.
Or at least wait till, like, I don't know, till they're away, they're out to dinner or something.
Yeah. Ah, fuck this movie.
Not work.
Yeah, work. Yeah, you dumb dumb. You dumb dumb ass.
Like he'd been there before.
Well, he hadn't been there before, actually.
True. Well, alright, that's a good point. I guess that's the point, right?
Yeah, I guess that is the point. But then again, fuck this movie. So where are we here? Okay, so the quarterback, ooh, I almost just gave away a shocker by describing him. The quarterback is driving down the road. He's contemplating life, and he runs into the back of a delivery truck that George Lopez is driving. Mm-hmm. All the flowers like fall out of the car, and George Lopez like realizes that it was the quarterback that hit him, and you know, the quarterback just like gives him a card and drives away from the scene. And it's
yeah.
It's 100% leaving the scene of an accident, so it's a hit and run.
No, it's his business manager will take care of it.
Yeah, dude, you can't just drive away, though, still.
Yeah, I guess not.
Like, he just...
Well, he was on a mission, dude. He's trying to figure out what he wants in life. It's Valentine's Day. You gotta forgive him.
Yeah, but still, that guy could, like... like, he's a moron. He just drives away. He, like, gets into an accident and just drives away.
Yeah.
Fuck. So now, okay. Like, the reveal of it is, like, that the little kid's flowers, Einstein's flowers, were in that truck, and they fell out. So, I don't know. Like, now you know that his day is going to be ruined, and I was so happy.
That his day is ruined, yeah.
Yeah. Which was great. I fucking hate little Einstein.
He's pissed now that his flowers weren't delivered too.
Yeah. Oh yeah. He like freaks out and he like runs into the car. Remember that like little weird thing that he does with the nose? He's like freaking out, and Emma Roberts, who is his babysitter, she's like, Einstein, calm down, like, remember what we do. And he, like, holds his nose, and he talks, and he's like, my day is ruined.
That was weird, so weird.
Yeah.
So he couldn't give his flowers to the crush that he wanted to in school.
Right, right.
Meanwhile, Ashton couldn't, yeah, let's wrap this up.
Let's skip so much of this shit. None of this fucking matters.
Yeah, yeah.
So, oh, okay. So, wait, no, hold on. We can wrap this up very quick. A lot of this stuff. All right. So, Jessica Alba, like, Ashton Kutcher comes home. He catches Jessica Alba about to, like, she is all packed up and ready to leave him. He catches her. He calls her out on it. And she's just like, yeah, this isn't going to work. I don't want to marry you. He just says, okay, and leaves.
Yeah.
He decides now that he needs to go and catch Jennifer Gardner, who is leaving for the plane. He then – that guy, the guy that was working at the gate of the airport, he just gives him a plane ticket. Incredibly illegal. Yeah. That is so like against everything after 9/11. Like that – he just gives him – he gives him
– yeah, it's
– it's crazy.
And listen, Southwest is great, but I mean, they're not giving out tickets.
No, that's not going to happen, man.
With any sob story.
Not going to happen, man.
Yeah.
And then, so he, the fuck happens? So he runs to Gardner. Go ahead, you.
Yeah, he runs to Gardner. He sees, because he delivered flowers to Dempsey's wife earlier in the day, and was like, listen, this dude... he's got a wife.
Oh, right. Yeah, he knows.
And he professes his true love for her because they've been best friends. Because George Lopez gives him advice to tell her how he feels.
Oh, yeah. He goes on. He moves on from, like, I'm engaged. I'm the happiest man in the world, like, with Jessica Alba. She leaves him, and he's just like, okay, I'm going to go after Jennifer Gardner.
Yeah, that was all in, like, 2 hours.
If that. If that.
What a day for Kutcher, huh?
Fuck him.
So he professes his love for her. She's like, she finds out that he's got a wife or whatever. She's pissed.
But she's still going to go. She still gets on the plane and goes.
Yeah, she still goes to mess with Dempsey. And she does.
Yeah.
Much in a way that you see in The Other Woman.
Yes.
So then, what happens next?
Who
else gets wrapped up?
Let me see. Let's wrap up Gardner real quick. She goes and finds out from the hospital that Patrick Dempsey isn't there. She then finds out where he's having dinner with his wife. She shows up, pretends to be Patrick Dempsey and his wife's waitress.
Makes a bunch of pig puns.
Ooh, so good. And then she basically steals from him.
Yeah.
Remember that the
she orders a bunch of stuff, like lobster tails and stuff.
Lobster tails and cheesecakes and stuff, and just puts it on his tab and leaves. You can't do that. I hope she goes to jail too in this movie.
Do you think? Yeah. Okay. Let's continue.
Let me see. You know that little kid Franklin in Einstein's class?
Yeah.
That kid was kind of funny. He's playing soccer and he puts his shirt up over his face and he stops like a bunch of goals. It was pretty dominant. I don't know. It was like a background thing, and I was watching that because this movie sucked, and I thought that was like great. I don't know.
Okay, that's
just something. These are the things that I write down, man. I don't know what this means. It says, "Oh, she need him in the gonads." I have no idea what that means. I don't know who it's about or what. I don't. We can skip that. Joey Keenan, my business partner. Does that mean anything to you?
It means nothing to me. Your notes seem like Charlie Day. Always Sunny.
Yeah. No. That actually does make sense now because it's about Einstein's grandparents.
Oh, yeah.
Einstein's grandparents have been married for like a long, long time. 50 years. And his grandma reveals to his grandpa on Valentine's Day that she had sex with his business partner while he was away. And that was what that means. He goes, it's the worst exposition of all time. She goes, oh, you know, Joey came. She's like, Joey came over. And he goes, Joey Keenan? My business partner, Joey Keenan? Like, all right, bro. Like, you would never say that in real life. You can clearly tell that this is written for a movie. And then I wrote, the old lady is a whore. Because she is. She's a whore. They eventually get back together. And then, whatever.
Yeah, they do. At the movie theater.
Yeah, she's dressed like a fucking asshole at the movie theater, too.
So, yeah. And then Topher Grace forgives Anne Hathaway for being a sex operator.
Yeah, he finds out at their Valentine's Day dinner because he walks outside and she's on the phone with somebody. They make up like incredibly quick.
That was really quick.
And
Roberts and her boyfriend realize they don't have to have sex to have a good Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Very noble. Great. Yeah. Fantastic. And then Julia Roberts and Bradley Cooper get off the plane.
Yeah, and – but before that, I was – like when the little kid – so the little Einstein finds Jennifer Gardner, who was his teacher, and the whole time the flowers were supposed to be for her. So Ashton Kutcher sees him and like gives him flowers, and Einstein goes in to Gardner and he's like, oh, these are for you. I want you to meet my Valentine, blah, blah, blah. And she's just like, no. Go give it to the Indian girl. And he does it, and then he's like really upset, and I was like so happy that this kid was like upset with his life. I seriously was, which is like sick. Wow. But
that's really sick, dude.
I'm just saying, dude.
It seemed like everyone got their happy ending though at the end, right?
Well, yeah, because you find out that Julia Roberts wasn't flying back to meet her husband. She was actually flying back to meet Einstein, who is her son. Ashton Kutcher and Gardner get together. Beale and Jamie Foxx get together. Topher Grace and Hathaway get together. Oh, the best one. The best couple in the whole movie. The quarterback, he admits that he's gay. And Bradley Cooper was actually his boyfriend or his partner or whatever. And they end up getting back together at the end of the movie. And good for them. That was the only couple I actually was cared about.
Yeah, that's true. Those are the only ones that I was like, you know what? I hope they stay together.
Me too.
How many of these couples do you think end up staying together for the long haul?
I hope none.
Other than the grandparents and Bradley Cooper and...
I hope none except for Cooper and the gay quarterback.
Yeah.
Fuck them all. They were all sucked. They were terrible. I hope Einstein never finds love. Oh, wait. Speaking of love...
How savvy was it, though, cast Emma Roberts as Julia Roberts' daughter?
No, they weren't daughter.
Oh, we weren't.
The babysitter. Right, yeah. Right.
Oh.
Yeah, no. You that would have been cool, though.
Of course, because nothing makes sense in this movie.
I know. Right. Today was a fairy tale played in it. There was, a long montage. And like we said before, we enjoy Taylor Swift's music, just not Taylor Swift.
They played it, three times.
Yeah, they did. They did. They played it multiple times. You're right.
It was like...
Oh, shit, you're right.
We're going to play this song a million times. I mean, great song.
It's a great song.
Very, very appropriate for the movie.
Oh, for sure. But, how about this? We were talking about love before. How about Topher Grace and Anne Hathaway both say that they love each other after 2 weeks?
2 weeks?
2 weeks.
That's
That's crazy talk.
That's like Jamie Lannister giving a 8-week present to anniversary gift to Cameron Diaz
True.
2 weeks ago.
True, man. Yeah,
these movies, man, they get the wrong ideas in people's heads.
Yeah, they give women false sense of what love is, and we're here to tell you what it really is.
It's not after 2 weeks, I'll tell you that. I know that for sure.
Yeah, no, it's for sure. You don't say that.
You can take that one to the bank.
Anthony,
that one's for free.
Sometimes, though, when you feel a type of way about a woman, you just have to tell her, man. And you know after 2 weeks. Even though that you know that she's a phone sex operator, you still feel that way deep down in your soul.
You know the best line of this movie was? It was the very end with that DJ.
Oh yeah.
When he was and it was just like that, you know, you feel a way, you want to say something.
Those three magic words, yeah. Go ahead.
What were they again? It was
Let's Get Naked, wasn't it?
Let's get naked, yeah. That was it. Let's Get Naked.
Yeah. So that guy, could you date a phone sex operator?
Could you date her?
Yeah, do you think you
would
could?
I be able, like if my girlfriend was like a phone sex operator, would I be like?
Yeah, like you found out. Yeah, like you found out. Would you be able to keep dating her?
Nah, I don't think I would care.
Me neither.
Yeah, probably.
You
wouldn't, or you would?
I wouldn't care, I don't think.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't care.
Yeah, me neither. Okay, good. I'm glad we're in lockstep with that, because that wraps it up quickly, because I didn't want to get too much into that, but...
Yeah.
I was just asking. I was curious, because I didn't really have a problem with it.
Me either. Who cares?
Because she had another job.
What's the big deal? She's making bank, dude. She's working for the agent and doing that on the side?
Right.
Yeah,
she had like
that's
a.
That's called the hustle.
That's
game
hustle,
right
baby. That's
I a, respect that.
It's a good woman. It's a good woman.
Exactly.
All right. Exactly. Well, we got through the end of that movie quick, so that's good. What do we got to do? We got a little bit of business left to do. Try to do this quickly.
Yeah, we got to appease our sponsors.
Yeah. All right. Let's do the ratings, I guess. Ratings. From IMDb, this is grossly overrated, 5.8.
Wow.
That is horrible. Oh, my God.
I bet you Rotten Tomatoes is pretty bad, though.
Rotten Tomatoes is it's really low. It is an 18.
Okay, I buy that.
Yeah, that's more like
it. I'm buying a whole lot of that 18% stock.
Yeah, I'm into the 18. Way more than a 5.8. Which yeah. Okay, so let's bring it to what do you want to do? You want to do the guess or the rating? Our ratings.
Our ratings.
All right, go ahead.
I would rate it a 2.6.
A 2.6. That is why? Why?
Bradley Cooper.
Good. That's a damn good reason.
That's the only reason. If he wasn't in it, it would be a 1.
Would you give it a 2.6 or an 8?
A 2.6.
Okay, that's fair. I'm gonna go off of the Rotten Tomato score. I'm giving it a 1.8.
1.8. Okay.
I absolutely hated this movie. It was pathetic.
You know what? I liked it more than The Other Woman.
I didn't. No, no. Get out of here.
The Other Woman tried too hard. It tried too hard. This one, like, you knew what you're getting yourself into. You're getting yourself in an ensemble cast that's supposed to make you feel good about Valentine's Day.
You know they made a movie like this called New Year's Eve, I think it was?
Yeah, well, we're not watching it because it has Katherine Heigl in it, and I refuse to watch anything with Katherine Heigl in it.
Okay, well.
So don't even go there.
Sofia Vergara is in it. I don't even.
If you trick me with a movie that Katherine Heigl's in, I will be so pissed.
I 100% will by the end of this. All right, so Greedo's gross guess. Wanna do it?
Yeah, let's go.
All right, so this movie came out. Obvious, I guess it was. I guess it came out on Valentine's Day.
Yeah, Valentine's Day, 2010.
2010.
Where were you?
Oh no, it actually came out February 12th, 2010.
Yeah, it was probably the Friday. Valentine's Day was probably the Sunday that year.
Yeah, it would have to be so.
I think that this made. Shit, it probably made a lot of money. I'm gonna go with 150 mil.
No, you're a little high, but yeah, no, you're in the
high.
Yeah, you're in the range though.
120.
Still a little high.
111.
Ooh, 110 mil.
Damn.
It's our second highest grossing movie so far. Face Off was 112.2.
Yeah, well, Face Off, please.
I'm just saying, that movie came out a lot earlier than this.
If you put inflation into Face Off, that's really like 190. Yeah, so.
No, but I mean, like, this made a lot of money. This made a lot of money.
Because all these schleps out there, they gotta appease.
I know.
They gotta bring their girlfriend to see Valentine's Day, like.
Yep.
Nah.
Yeah, I'm gonna do this quick. I want to do this really quick. But there's a few like weird like trivia things. So Julia Roberts is like really not in this movie at all, and she has 251 words of dialogue. Yet she made $3 million. So they broke it down, and she made almost $12,000 for every word she said in this movie.
That's absurd. That's what you get for being America's sweetheart.
Like that. Oh my God.
$3 million just for Julia Roberts. They had 20 other people they had to pay millions of dollars for.
I know, man.
What was the budget of this movie? What did they break even for this movie?
I don't know. This is the second biggest opening for a romantic comedy behind Sex and the City.
So. God.
Oh,
man.
Shit. Here you go. Katherine Heigl was considered for a role in the movie but was dropped because of salary demands.
She probably wanted 10 mil for every word. Yeah, they could have a nice Grey's Anatomy reunion in this show, in this movie.
Well, there was that 70s show reunion.
What? Yeah.
Ashton Kutcher and Topher Grace.
That's true. Yeah, they kept it pretty close together.
You said before about the cast. It features one of the largest ensembles cast in Hollywood history.
Yep. That doesn't surprise me at all.
And it also, surprisingly enough, at the time of this movie's release, it had collectively been nominated, like the actors had been collectively nominated for 16 Oscars.
Yeah,
which,
there's a lot of good actors.
Like Kathy Bates, Jamie Foxx, Anne Hathaway, Queen Latifah, Shirley MacLaine, who's the old lady, and Julia Roberts. Like, that's a ton of, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Fuck.
How do they get all these people to do this?
I don't know, man.
I guess it's the money, dude.
Sure. I mean, this made a lot of money.
How many days of work do you think each of these people put in for this? A week? All in the movie for like not even 10 minutes each.
It was shot in 53 days.
Yeah. So.
Yeah.
Shit. Huh. Maybe we'll be in the next one.
I want to be in the next one.
Yeah, dude. Maybe we'll be extras.
I'm just kidding. I would never be in this movie. You got anything else?
I don't. This movie was terrible.
Yeah, it was horrible.
See something better on Valentine's Day.
Go see 50 Shades of Grey.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. I don't know. I heard that was a bad movie.
I did too. I think we're going to do that next.
Is it coming next? You're going to make me go to the movie theater by myself and watch that movie?
No, I'll find it for you.
All right. I'm still going to go to the movies.
Tucci State. Do it real quick.
Tucci should have been in this movie because I had everyone else that was up for an Oscar in this movie. I think Tucci would have been really good as let's see, who could have Tucci been? Tucci should have been someone's dad.
Okay. I would have liked him as George Lopez's role. Like Ashton Kutcher's friend.
Yeah, like a wiser.
Exactly. Instead of a wise Mexican guy, it was like just a wise, like awesome Tucci. Awesome Tucci.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree.
All right.
I agree.
All right, good. I think that's
I'm kind of glad that Tucci wasn't in this actually.
Me too.
I didn't want to see him suffer through
this. Yeah, I would have felt bad if he was in this.
Yeah.
You said don't see this movie, right? See something better?
Yeah, don't see this movie. See something
don't
better.
See it. Like, seriously, I know Valentine's Day has passed and we kind of screwed up because we were both away.
We watched this together on Valentine's Day.
Don't even put that in people's minds. That did not happen. But
how was your Valentine's Day?
We spent it together. I mean, that part's not a lie. We were together for it. But I wish we could have gotten this out to people before Valentine's Day because I really don't want – like if people watch this, I feel really bad. Because we could have stopped.
I feel like it's almost too late now.
We could have stopped people from watching it. No, it's not too late. It's too late for those people if they watched it, yeah.
Yeah, it's too late for you.
But
if you're thinking about watching it next year or any year after this,
yeah, don't
watch it.
Break up.
I was really surprised at the reactions I got when I told people I've never seen this movie.
Yeah, I was surprised that you've never seen it because I've seen this movie previously.
Never.
I didn't remember it. I think I blocked it out. But
first time and only time. I hope I never see it again.
Oh, I'll never watch this movie again.
No matter how many times it's on TNT.
Yeah. Well, we done?
All right.
I think we're done.
Cue the music. Sing to me, Taylor.
I hate this movie. Yeah, it's going to be Taylor. All right. So, until next time, friends, thank you for listening.
Taylor was a fairy tale. You were the prince. I used to be a damsel in distress. You took me by the hand and you picked me up at 6. Today was a fairy tale. Today was a fairy tale. Today was a fairy tale. I wore a dress. You wore a dark gray t-shirt.